Howdy folks, Jake here with the Banjo Bin General Store, and today I'm going to show you one of the most ancient and valuable string changing tips known to man from the beginning of time until now, and that is the luthier's knot. So it's quite simple. Let's assume we already know what we're doing down here. Up here is where things get tricky. So most of the time when you're changing a string, folks with little experience, they'll just run it in there and just tighten it. And that can kind of work sometimes if the string binds, but what's going to happen most of the time, you'll have slippage, it won't stay in tune well, etc. So what this technique will do is make sure that the string holds real tight to the post. So what I do when I'm changing the strings, I'll line up this tuner post hole so it's in line with the string. And then we'll just run the loose end of the string through the post like so. And here's where you have to start paying attention. So you pull it tight and pull the slack out and mark about, say, an inch and a half or so, a couple inches maybe with your left hand above the tuner post. And this is true for all six strings. We do the same thing. Then we'll pull it back to about there. That'll give us about the amount of slack we need, okay? So here's the knot part. Here's the trick. Here's where you have to pay really close attention. We're going to take the loose end of the string here like so. It's going to wrap around to the inside of the headstock. So you noticed these tuners are on this side and we want the loose end of the string to go to the inside of the headstock. If we were on this side, it would be the opposite. We'd bring the loose string in this way. So we're going to wrap it to the inside of the headstock, reach underneath the actual part of the string that we won't clip off, the useful part that we'll tune up. And we're going to pull it underneath that. So you see we're creating a kind of a D loop there where the loose end is coming underneath the actual part of the string that we'll use. So at this point, what you do is just give it a snug pull so it's tight. And it runs right up under the string, and then what we're going to do is take the part we have in the loose end we have in this hand, we're going to kink it over the top like so. Just like that. So that's all there is to the knot part. Now what we'll do is take your winder, or you can do it by hand if you'd rather, if you don't have a winder. Winder's faster, put it on there. And we're going to turn the post so that the string will go to the inside also. Everything is to the inside, no matter which side you're on. So this part of the string here will go to the inside, and it's gonna come down the post. So you kinda have to manipulate it there. And then you see it goes under that first wind, that first wrap, and then you just go ahead and tighten it up like so. And then we have a beautiful luthier's knot. And that's all there is to it. Cut off the excess, and you will never have to change strings again until the next time. Hope that helps.